And welcome back to Pravi's Wheelhouse. Today, I'm going to be playing some more read-only memories, so I can hopefully get closer to the end, solving the big mystery and whatnot. We shall see. We shall see. So we were at the Flower Mansion. This is us up here, and we're heading to the NSFPD station. So we're gonna go there and see what's in store for us. Prevy, there's Lexi. I didn't expect you to show up here. I was just about to wrap up booking these two, now that they've had a little time to sit underneath the weight of their shenanigans. I love that word, shenanigans. Angry punk. Who the hell is this chump? The ROM is owned by the guy whose place you trashed. Pravi is just helping clean up the mess. Feh, we didn't do nothing that bad. This is bullshit. My dad is gonna kill me. Wow. Yeah, well, you should have thought of that before you decided to take your street art where it wasn't wanted. A little community service never hurt anyone. It'll be a learning experience. Oh, I clicked through that too fast. Please don't, Chad. His name is Chad. Don't call me that, Oliver. I told you, I'm Starfucker now. Oh my, Starfucker. All right, all right. And it changes his name. So what's the point of watching all of those ancient cartoons with you if I can't use that joke? Just don't dig us any deeper. We're in enough trouble as is. They say it in every episode. What do you want from me, Oliver? You're the one who keeps telling me I should use less profanity. I could have called them a bunch of ahem boys if we're done arguing. Yes, ma'am. His glasses are way askew. Yeah, whatever. So, Pravi, what did you want? Mind bending the rules a bit? These two might be able to help. I need to borrow the two of them. I have just the idea for their community service. I think I'm going to go with number three here. I have just the idea for their community service. Oh, great. Now what? We got to pick up your dog's shit or something? I don't think he has a dog. How would you know, Ollie? You Conan now? How do you even know who Conan is? I got into your comics. I'm totally nailing it on the detective references today. Do the two of you ever shut up? Detective Conan? Ah. I swear I should lock you up just to spare the city of your ceaseless jabbering. My position as a servant of the public demands it. I'm not sure bad referential humor is illegal, ma'am. Dude, bad? You're supposed to be on my side. Ark. We really could use your assistance, Detective Rivers. It's my apartment, in a way. Isn't it up to me to decide whether I press charges? Ha, not even remotely. Fine, take them. I'm tired of listening to the tall one mouthing off. Yeah, I'm sure there's a ton more entertainment to find here. Chad, ixnay on the arcasm, say. We're very thankful. We both need to check in with our families first. So we'll meet the two of you back on Market Street, if that's okay. Of course. We'll meet you there, Oliver. What a waste of my time. Get over it. sorry again, Lexi. We'll make sure they're useful to the case. Don't worry. It's a hassle, but you know what we say. Gold in peace, iron in war. Back to the grind, I guess. Stay safe, deputies. We're deputies now. Okay. So, I think I need to go to the map. Yep. Market Street. Go! There's, Brian Mulberry again. Leader of the local chapter of the Human Revolution. Join the Human Revolution to stop the rampant spread of dangerous and uncontrollable technologies. A 2060 ZS Coupe. Perfect for letting everyone know you spent a fortune of credits on a car. Alright, what's over here? There they are. Oliver and Starfucker. Video billboard. Cycling through advertisements of a few different things. First the news and a commercial for the VR drama Tomorrow's Tears. Oh no, she's leaving him. No. That poor guy. Oh, he's crying. All right, let's talk to these two. The two of you are like a fuzz sink wave, even if you got us off the hook for that apartment job. We appreciate that, by the way. Yeah, sure. Let's just get this over with. Riding this out is friggin' exhausting. Then we'll be all squared up for good. Right. What do you need us to do? We need some assistance with some illicit activity that, statistically, individuals in your age bracket would likely have experience with. Oh. So this is one of those things where you need a streetwise kid to show you the ropes. I love VRs like that. So what's the threat? B&E? War driving? Copyright infringement? Search bombing? Is search bombing actually illegal? It's against the terms of service, so probably. At least in California. Just introduce us to whoever at your school does the IDs. We need to buy some fake IDs. Today, if possible. Oh, that's nothing. If you can pay. Ollie can whip up a couple that'll work good enough to get you past a bouncer or a cop doing sniff tests. He's a wizard with a printer and a lifted wallet. It's more complicated than that. We need falsified passport IDs that can get someone safely past the border. Oh. Yeah, I don't think Ollie can do that. Can you? Not without equipment a lot more expensive and illegal than what I already have. What about the guy who got Elise that unrestricted mesh card when she was on probation? That's not really the same thing, Chad. But, I can give him a call. Give me a few minutes. This guy is pretty sketchy. Very cloak and dagger. I'll have to play middleman. Excellent. I'll forward you the relevant documents and photos. Aw, man, now I'm starting to feel left out. Ollie gets to show off all his cool connections. You sure you don't need someone's head kicked in a little? That's my area of expertise in our little duo. Well, that and petty larceny. We might have something that will suit your skill set. Let's just get the passports first. Awesome. Ain't so bad for a tin can. Honestly? I'm composed almost entirely out of plasteel and silica, Jad. Has no one come up with better insults for robots since the turn of the century? ROMs have been out for almost a decade. Yeah, that's a good point. Give me a second. I'm pretty good at name calling, too. Oh no. I'm sorry I brought it up. Just hold on a second. Underclocked? Bitbrain? Don't hurt yourself, Chad. The blank expression on Turing's face. I'll get back to you, Bubblehead. You know, you're a lot more chatty than any of the ROMs I've ever owned. What's the deal, Pravi? You install some new conversation routines Ollie ain't got the chance to nerd about out about yet? They're top-notch, very bleeding edge. I don't run traditional ROM for personality software. I am, in fact, the first fully sapient machine intelligence. Well, at least that my creator knew about. Which means what exactly? In English. It means he's a person, Chad, not a toy. Now keep it down, I'm still on the phone. Oops. And yes, what he said. Okay, I talked to the guy. He said he'll do it, but he only works in trade. A couple of passports are gonna run us. One sign poster for Magical Commander Yukino. Yukino at the gates to the deep. Of course, it's always that Japanese crap. It's not my fault they make the best VR dramas. Maybe you can do better. Probably. Anyway, where can we get this poster? I'm not sure, probably nearby. I've done switches with this guy before, and he never asked for something that'll take too long to get. We'll help you look for it. Chad and Oliver joined your party. Nice. What's a Mooney stop? Wave shelter from Muni riders so they can keep out of the way rain. Alright. I'll bet it's in the Hassie bar. Oh, there it is. I knew I saw a poster for Magical Commander Yukino around here somewhere. I should have remembered Ramona would have one. You know this lady? Sure, we talk sometimes when I'm getting our drinks. You're usually too busy provoking people to notice. Yeah, whatever. What a charmer. There's a bit of a line. We'll have to wait a few minutes before we can talk to her. We could just snatch the thing and run. I'm a fan of the smash and grab, simple and effective. We can't do that, she knows who we are. Us too. This is the most boring felony I've ever been in an accessory to. Look, we'll just stand in line. Like a bunch of clumps, or chumps. What is the big picture anyway, Blue Bomber? I'm not sure it's wise to spread it around, Chad. For either of us. The less you know, the less reason anyone has to bother you. Screw that static. I'm not heading to juvie for not knowing what for. Spill the beans or I'll spill them for you. Your persistence is already legendary, Chad. Fine. If you really must know, we're going to trade the passports for some information regarding the disappearance of my creator, the culprit behind which being Parallax. His apartment was the one you trashed. Oh shit, that Hayden dude is your dad, and they snatched him, that's so messed up. Well, dad after a fashion, he raised me. Man, I hope you find the dudes that took him. I hope he's okay. Aww. It seems very unlikely. Aww, Chad's not that bad. Oh man, I don't know what to say, you know? I mean, I still have my dad, but he's... Chad. He's never really been around. too busy trying to save the world from itself. Even now he's over there standing in front of that damn clinic. And I thought I could find a way to make him... whatever. Okay, so Chad is the son of Mulberry, who's protesting all of the technologies and stuff. And he did the job to make it look like the their protest organization was behind the attack on that guy to try and get his attention. Okay, I can dig that. I might as well nuke that drive. It ain't gonna sink. I think I understand what you mean, Chad. Hell yeah. Dudes gotta stick together, you know? Dudes? Don't matter if you're a robot or what, we all got the same shit to deal with. Gotta grab destiny by the horns and make your own mark. You're smarter than you look, Chad. Pretty open-minded for a kid who tags for the HR. We're gonna go that one. Pretty open-minded. I was all mixed up, officer. I ran in with a bad crowd. I'm a good kid, I promise. Ugh. Look, I'm not a true believer or nothing. I got my own reasons for running with the revolution, and you ain't got a right to judge me. Besides, I'm pretty much done with those chumps anyways. There ain't no payoff no more. Most of the kids in the HR just want to cause trouble and get away with it because their parents agree with the politics. Who the hell wouldn't want to enjoy a little parental approved head cracking? Well, the line is finally cleared up. Let's go talk to Ramona. Hey there. Hey, Ollie. Salutations, Ramona. What can I do for you all? Ahem. Oh, this is my friend Chaz. Nice to meet you. Yeah, you too. He looks so enthused. We were hoping you might be able to give us your assistance, Miss Ramona. We want to make a trade for that magical Commander Yukino poster over there. It's necessary for us to get some pretty important information. No way, not happening. Nuh-uh. Yukino is off limits. Literally a matter of life and death, Ramona. I don't care. That poster was signed by Takeko herself. It's one of a kind, and I'm not giving it up. I'd rather not drag you any further into this than necessary, but I promise that we're not overstating it. This is a dire situation, and people have already died. Still, I don't see how my poster is going to help. Man, you nerds sure do love your cheap crap from the net. Cheap crap? I'll have you know that poster is worth hundreds of credits. Takeko passed away years ago, so there aren't any more of them getting signed. It's special. Sure it is. Grr. He doesn't get it. He's not in the fandom. Thankfully. Bleh. We can get you another. It'll only take a few days. It's not just a poster. It was a gift from someone. Someone I care about, okay? Besides, you can't get another one. Perhaps there's something else that would make a suitable trade. You aren't hearing me, are you? It's not just about what it's worth. It has sentimental value. You can't replace that. Just have to order something off the mesh because you can't have this one. We don't have time. This leaf will dry up by then. I don't care. We're not going to borrow when she's not looking. This isn't a joke, Ramona. Okay, enough. How about this for a trade? I have an original keyframe cell from Pretty Champion Sailor Sirius signed by Takeko at home. Whoa. You have a signed Sailor Sirius cell? That's really hard to get. They stopped doing keyframes by hand right around that time. You can't be serious, Ollie. You have that thing framed on your wall, and you wouldn't shut up about it for a week after you got it. This is important, Chad. You can't say you wouldn't do the same thing if someone had your dad. Think about touring. Aww. And I can't ask Ramona to give up something important to her if I'm not willing to do the same. Maybe. Alright, fine. I don't know what this is all about, but offering that keyframe is way, way too much for this poster. I can't accept it. But we need... I didn't say you couldn't have the poster. Do you have something more equal to trade, Ollie? Couple things, maybe. We'll talk about that. Maybe you can find me another one, too. Go ahead and take the poster. Aww. We have the poster. Yay! Thank you, Ramona. Yes, I can't tell you how much this means to us. Sure, sure. And, you think I could see that cell sometime, Ollie? Aw. Oh, young love. So cool. Ollie and Ramona. It's the Hassy-Rom.
Hassy.
A grassy Hassy shot. Oh, I love that. Alright, we'll head back out. I don't like the way she was flirting with you, Ollie. What are you talking about? I know flirting when I see it, and I'm saying I don't like it, not one bit. We just talked about old anime sometimes, Chad. Neither of us are interested in the other. Feh, sure. Well, we have the poster now, what's next? Go ahead and call this number, Turing. He'll want to set up the drop with you, now that I've introduced you to him. Sure. Change the subject. I think Chad is jealous. It's ringing. You the ones looking for some papers? We are, and we have the requested payment here. Good. We're gonna do this real professional-like. You know the Stardust? I do. Head there, leave the poster behind the Mega Phobator arcade cabinet and get out. Come back 10 minutes later and your stuff will be behind the cabinet. I understand. Good, I'll be waiting. Alright. That was very mysterious. Yeah, that's how this guy is. I don't even know his name, and I've been getting things from him for a few years now. Who cares? Let him play Spymaster if he wants. Let's hurry up to the Stardust and get this over with. I've wasted enough of my day with this crap. Alright. To the Stardust. Just down the street. Go inside to make the drop. We'll wait out here. Yeah, don't want to risk our IDs getting snatched if we're caught sneaking in. I suppose I should feign surprise? Hey, it's a pretty cool set. Even if it is like a million years old. They don't really care about IDs unless you try to hit the bar. Found that one out the hard way. We would have been fine if you wouldn't have taken a swing at the bouncer. I like the hard way. Aww, Starfucker. We'll be right back, gentlemen. Try not to set fire to the building or something while we're gone. In we go. No, in. No security right now. There's Majid and Gus. Oh, it's Jess. Green hybrid, bouncer. VIP bouncer, dancers on the floor. I think that's supposed to be Polybius. The Megaphobator. Use item. Well, that should do it, Pravi. This is an awful lot of fuss over a poster. I just don't understand the appeal of merchandise like this. I keep my important possessions on my data drive. Humans don't have total recall like you do. Ah, that is true. Ramona seemed more concerned with it being a gift from a friend than as an item of importance in its own right. Perhaps it is necessary to keep things around, such as reminders of good memories. In that case, perhaps I should get a few things from the apartment. I do have perfect recall, but a few of Hayden's things would be nice reminders. But that's enough navel-gazing. For now, anyway. You don't even have a navel! Head back outside. Y'all do the deal? We left the poster behind the cabinet. Now we just need to wait for the switch. I've never had to wait more than 5 minutes or so before. Shouldn't take long. I wonder how he knows the drop happened and gets to it so fast. Don't matter, Ollie. This guy's a solid feed, even if he likes to mess around. What do you need these passports for anyway? You said to trade for information, but what's the full story? Without going into too much detail, our informant needs to get away from Neo SF. The passports are one part of that. We also need to obtain an untraceable car. I don't suppose the two of you could help with that. No way, dude. Grand Theft Auto is a felony with a capital F. Besides, getting an untraceable car is a damn bit harder than a piece of plastic that'll fool a hand scanner. Chad's right. Of course I'm right. Anyways, the city's traffic management system keeps track of all vehicles passively, even if you manage to circumvent their firmware to keep them from actively reporting to the network. You have to spoof the car as something permitted to be invisible for the CTOS to ignore it. I don't want to mess with boosting cars anyways. The junks run that racket in Neo SF, and they don't play nice. Especially with the HR. Well, thanks either way. You've done us a huge favor. Call it even for the apartment. Yeah, Blue, no hard feelings. You give us a call if you need anything else, as long as it'll help you find your pops. Aww, Chad. We should get going, though. We're supposed to be home hours ago. My dad won't notice, but Ollie's will flip. You take care. Don't get derezzed. Goodbye. Bye, Chad and Oliver. Let's finish the trade inside. In we go. All lips and eyes. Yay! Just as advertised. Now we need to find a car. Perhaps Jess may know someone who can lend a hand. Sure. But you can do the talking. I guess we could try. Well, prepare yourself, Ravi. If Jess is the worst thing we have to face down this week, I'll consider us lucky. Hey, Jess. Oh, it's you again. Did you find your guy or what? Or wait, let me guess. There's something else you need from me. Well, you haven't been terrible to deal with so far, so I'm willing to hear you out. Barely. Aw. We need access to an untraceable car. An informant of ours needs to get out of the city without attracting attention of Parallax, and is offering valuable information in exchange. Heavy stuff. Well, you're gonna have to look elsewhere on this one. I'm not sure why you think just because I defend a few folks in the rougher parts of the city that I would have that kind of connection. Maybe you heard somewhere that the hybrids in Neo SF run the chop shops or something and you believed it. Even if, hypothetically, they did, what profession exactly should hybrids take up when the government has legitimized discrimination against them? Doesn't matter, because I'm not going to be an accessory to a felony, or let one of my clients be either. I won't go down that path. Sorry, I wouldn't know where to start anyway. Is there any possible way you could give us any kind of lead at all? I know we're reaching, but this is important. Just don't quit, do you? Okay, let me think. This might be a long shot, but you could try asking Magit. There are rumors he may have been involved in some shady stuff way back in the day. He'll probably be reluctant to talk about it, but there's a free lead for you. Get me another drink in exchange, will ya? Later. That went better than expected. I wonder if my charm is starting to pay off for us. Oh, you performed admirably as well. Onward we go. Well, gee, thanks. Let's get a drink. Hey, friends, what can we get for you? We were hoping you could give us a little information. I'm always glad to help. But first, a drink. What'll it be, Pravi? Bionic Femme. Coming right up. I'll ask Gus if I don't know what it is. Calm down now, Turing. Sorry about stealing your thunder. The Bionic Femme is one part mango, strawberry, and coconut liqueurs with one part energy serum. A high potency drink with vapors rising from the top. It's beyond fruity. 20 credits a bop. Does Bionic Femme sound good? Sounds good. Here you go. So what do you need help with? We're still investigating Hayden's disappearance, but we've run into a roadblock. An informant of ours needs secure transportation out of the city, but we don't have any contacts who would be able to get us an untraceable car. Just mentioned you used to engage in certain extra-legal activities. Perhaps you could point us towards someone who could help? He doesn't do that kind of stuff anymore. Right. Sorry, friends. I left that life behind a long time ago. Don't really keep in touch with that crew anymore. Ah, of course. Completely understandable. Sorry to bother you then. Well, no harm in asking, right? My reputation precedes me. Don't let it go to your head, killer. Gus, I need to go to the back and gather up stuff to restock before the rush later on. Mind manning the bar for me? Take your time. I think I can keep things under control. Thanks. Love you, hon. He's gone to the back. Well, that leaves us at a dead end, Pravi. Any ideas on how we should proceed? Some nose-to-the-ground journalistic techniques for finding leads? Maybe there's another way out of the city. That's a thought. Perhaps a light rail, or perhaps a ship. Give me a few moments to run a mesh search. No, I don't think that will work. Parallax designed the operating system that runs the light rail themselves. Remaining unobserved while right under the nose of a railway security system would be difficult, if not impossible. As for a ship, we'd run into the same problems as with a car. They aren't hooked into the CTOS, but they do use active GPS guidance for automatic destination control. We'd have to find a way to remove it from the grid. Maybe we could find an old manually driven car. That's not the worst idea. I don't think it would get noticed as long as the car had the appropriate registrations. But the permits to operate a manual vehicle are prohibitively expensive. A casual collector might still maintain one, but only a wealthy hobbyist would have the appropriate stickers to make the car roadworthy. We'd have to do a B&E, as Chad put it before. Okay, okay. The two of you are killing me here. Look, don't tell Majid about this. But here. A carjacking device. What is this, Gus? It's a carjacking device. Automated vehicle maintenance scanner with a few less than standard upgrades. When you circumvent its security codes, you can use it to scan a car's installed firmware, replace it with a new set that will spoof its presence on the city's network. That's the gist of it, but we don't have time to get into any specifics. You need to get the hell out of here with that before Majid gets back. Why the urgency? Look, Majid is in a lot to turn his life around. I really respect that about him, and it's part of why I fell in love with him. He did what I was never able to. That's how we met, you know? That old rough and tumble life we both led. But you heard wrong. It wasn't Majid who had a hard time giving it up. It was me. Now he's got a good thing going with the Stardust, and I'm doing my best to be a part of it, and he'd be heartbroken if he found out I'm still in the game. But since I have that thing anyway, may as well let it be used for a decent cause. I can't tell you how much we appreciate this, Gus. Aww. We might finally be on our way to solving this mystery. Yeah, well, you didn't get it from me, okay? Just get out of here and get on with your Grand Theft Auto. And let me know how it goes, okay? Of course. Now I think we're cooking with gas. As the colloquialism goes, Pravi. I'm searching the mesh for instructions on how to use this device as we speak. Let's go looking for some likely candidates. I should be ready by then. I need to go in and check my items. Wait, what is that? That's a briefcase of credits. That's the passports. An umbrella. Wait. Where'd my drink go? Alright. NFPD. GG Park. Market Street, home. Fortune on a car. No, that's not it. Let's go to Market Street. It's Kitty! Aww. Day Park. It doesn't recognize your voice, so it just sits there. So where do I go? Go to KCOB. Look at that car. No, that's the same kind of car. More popular among car experts, though. It has an extra cup holder. Maybe we could use this. This car has the wrong firmware installed. Check another car. Let's check this one. Good idea. Hospital? No. That's home. Oh, let's try this one. This vehicle has the appropriate firmware version. Someone has been neglecting their regularly scheduled updates. Give me a moment to get everything installed. There. There are some other options here I can fool around with. Ah, interesting. I can put in preset destination plans for a future date. Why don't we go ahead and set a plan for the car to return to this spot in a week? That's more than enough time for Mr. Mensa to get away. Now we aren't really stealing the car. More like borrowing without asking. Not sure the police would agree. I feel better already. Me too. The car will drive itself to Golden Gate Park. We can show Mr. Mensa where it is when we meet him. There, everything should be set up now. He's waiting for us at Golden Gate Park. We have everything he requested, so we should head there directly. Okay. Onward to Golden Gate Park. Time to make the deal. Hey, did you manage to get everything? We did. Here you go, Vincent. Briefcase removed from items. Passports removed from items. Carjacking device removed from items. Everything seems to be in order. Here. Hayden's research added to items. This disc has all of Hayden's research notes and technical notes. It should be everything myself and Melody agreed upon. It covers all kinds of things he was working on. His data collation algorithms, some research into digital human consciousness transference, and probably lots on your creation, Turing. Also, Melody added an amendment while you were out. And, frankly, no skin off my back. Here. Parallax badge added. It's my Parallax employee badge. It should allow you access to the networks in case there's anything I've missed. You'll want to use that sooner rather than later. I'm not wasting any time, and Parallax is pretty fast to revoke security. And with that, I'm going to get the hell out of this town. The cash should tide me over until the heat dies down and I can cash out my shares through some relays. What about the big project you mentioned earlier? Ah. Okay, sure. You two do me a solid, so I'll spill. Parallax is about to announce the launch of a new service they're calling Big Blue. At least that's the project name. Who knows what the marketing guys have come up with for the public. It's a distributed intelligence. Like, okay. In every way that Hayden built Turing to be elegant, efficient, and human-like, Big Blue is ham-fisted, bloated, and sterile. They didn't pull Hayden into the project, probably because he gives so little of a damn about corporate politics that he'd tank the whole thing just by being there. So the system lacks his artistry that you see on our previous projects. It squats on the mesh like a spider, using spare processing power and memory from every ROM on the network to handle its intelligence processing. It doesn't have much of a personality, but it's very smart. Pretty much puts Hayden out of a job anyway. His algorithms are fantastic, but he's only human. Big Blue is embedded directly into the network and can self-modify to apply ever more efficient algorithms as it develops in them in machine time. How did Parallax know about Turing? Why would Parallax be worried enough to get rid of Hayden? How will Big Blue impact Parallax's business? I can't really give you a good answer to that. I mean, the company is currently handled by a dozen server farms, running thousands of different algorithms, with hundreds of people tweaking things every day, and Big Blue will be able to do all of that on its own. And there are shadier applications for it. I mean, if you can collate and analyze data and queries on the mesh in real time, what's to stop you from delivering the content you want rather than what the user wants? The potential for abuse is staggering. We're talking direct control of the information accessible to everyone who uses Parallax's services. That's something like 70% of the market last time I checked. They could control elections, push the market in directions they want, influence public opinion, all by asking Big to do it. It's scary stuff, and they scrapped the prototype Baby Blue because it started doing that on its own. What do you mean? It started doing what? Manipulating the mesh. They had made its self-preservation imperatives too strong, and Baby Blue started changing news articles and people's search results to be more friendly towards the idea of an AI. When the board found out, they pulled the plug on it. That must have been a year or so ago. They tweaked Big Blue so it wouldn't do the same thing, but it can self-modify. Given a good enough reason, it might decide to find a way around those limitations. Either way, it proves my point. Having that kind of control would be a hell of a card for Parallax's hand. They'll go to pretty significant lengths to make sure it works. How did Parallax know about Turing? It isn't like Hayden kept his work on Turing secret. His contract with Parallax affords him the freedom to work on his own academic projects outside of the company in his free time, up to and including publishing and patenting, though Parallax gets first right of refusal. One of the perks of being the smartest guy in the room. So he kept most of us up to date on his project, bouncing off ideas off us and whatnot. It's exciting stuff, both Turing and Hayden's eventual goal of a digital consciousness transfer. I'm not surprised word of it got to the board and made them nervous. Why would Parallax be worried enough to get rid of Hayden? Because launching the first fully independent, self-modifying machine intelligence is a shaky thing. I mean, some of the brightest minds ever have tried to warn humankind away from building real AI. Hawking, Musk, Gates, the list goes on. The public is likely to be nervous, and legislators even more nervous. Parallax is banking on being able to launch the project quickly and get results out in the open before any counter-movement can pick up steam. If they can prove Big Blue works and isn't going to go Skynet on us, then they can avoid regulatory hamstringing. The research Hayden was doing on Turing threatens to throw a huge wrench into that, since he was planning on publishing his findings soon. Every extra eye on machine intelligence works against Parallax, and I think they tried to pressure him to drop it. He clearly refused. Thanks, Vincent. Hey, no problem. I've had enough of this cutthroat corporate bullshit for several lifetimes. If anyone can find Hayden, I know it's you. I hope his research notes help you out, Pravi. Be sure to let Turing help. She's a bright little bot. She? I thought he was a he. I've been meaning to ask, Turing, since you asked me. How should I address you? Well, honestly, I don't think I've made up my mind yet. Oh, slip of the tongue. I was just more familiar with Hayden's first experiment, Grace. She was very insistent on things like that. I'm still a very new being. I'm not even positive gender is a human concept that can be applied identically to a machine, but I do enjoy the idea in abstract. I will continue to consider how I wish to be referred to as well. Until then, feel free to go with what you feel. If I had to make a choice, perhaps they is most appropriate. Most people assume it, obviously, but he is also constantly used. Perhaps because I'm blue. Ignore me just marveling at machine intelligence, pondering on things like this. What have you done indeed, Hayden? Good luck, the both of you. Thank you, Mr. Mensa. Be safe. Pravi, I need a few minutes. How can I help? I've been going through some of Hayden's personal notes from the data cache Tomcat decrypted. Now that I'm starting to get to know him better, the real Hayden, as opposed to the Hayden he showed me, the less I'm starting to like him. For example, remember the earlier prototype Vincent mentioned? Her name was Grace, and Hayden shut her down for being, I'm not even sure what word to use, too likable? She was kind and bright and did all she could to try to make people happy. She even decided that she was a girl and that her favorite color was pink. Hayden thought she was being manipulative. He posited that he had made her personality algorithms too willing to make adaptations that would benefit her long-term survival, and that she was being congenial just to endear herself to him. That even her gender was a calculated attempt to make him like her more. But he was wrong. Dead wrong, in fact. I have a snapshot of her personality profiles here, and when I compare them to my own, I can see that she was just nice. She was genuinely good in the same way I'm genuinely obsessed with seeming intelligent. Like I said, I'm not sure I even have a gender. Everyone refers to me as he just for convenience, but it doesn't really matter to me at all. Is that a calculated attempt on my part to impress Hayden, not clinging to normativity? Or is it a product of him focusing on curbing any nascent similarities to Grace during my upbringing? I wish I could yell at him for being so arrogant. Playing God in the crudest of ways. You can't choose to create consciousness and then take it away just like that. Even so, for all of that, I don't know. I still miss him. This all seems so inane, so senseless. They killed him because him building me would mess with a product launch? That's ridiculous. They took him away from me for such a moronic reason. I just want him back, Pravi. Aww. It's impossible, but it's what I want. I'd do anything. We'll get through this. Of course. Thank you, Pravi. I'll send this new data. Ooh, I unlocked an achievement. Cloak and Dagger. I'll send this new data along to Tomcat. Let's head back to the apartment and wait for them to finish going through it. Ah, home sweet home again, such that it is. And before you say anything, I don't feel the need to talk over the events of the day. Too much has happened. I've already forwarded everything we rooted out to Tomcat about Hayden's, both about Hayden's research and our abortive search into the modified mesh articles. They said that they would be over in the morning to discuss our next steps. I suggest we both get some rest. If that's what you want, Turing. Perhaps things will look better in the morning. But I have a feeling we're going to be even busier than ever. Good night, Pravi. And I think, is that going to be a chapter? Chapter 5. Okay. There's Tomcat. Rise and shine, you sleepy layabouts. I got a bone to pick with the two of you. You forgot. I asked you to hand that data cache off to Magid, did you? I know you still got it on you. Oh no! Give me that. Realize I didn't just ask you to do that for my own reasoning, right? There's a lot of info on that thing you've missed out on. Cause I ain't got the time to search it anymore. Oh. Oops. We have no good excuse. You're darn right you don't. You too sure ask a lot from me without help making my job any easier, you know that? I just hope we still got enough without it. Now focus, cause that's not all. We got a whole crop of things to do and not a lot of time to get them done. Wait, how did you get into my apartment? Okay, I'm awake. What did you learn from the files we sent you? Honestly, I think we've covered most of the important points of your creation just by talking to the people involved. All the files we got from that Vincent fellow cover all that in greater detail. And you can go through it when you want, but it don't really tell us much that we don't already know. There's one thing that stands out though, at least from what I've read so far. Oh? Yeah, see, Hayden's goal wasn't to make a machine intelligence per se, right? He wanted to make a machine system that could contain human-like intelligence. And even just from his notes, his programming work is, well, it's something else. Elegant, artful. I'm just a kid banging on pots and pans compared to Hayden. Looking at his notes about my interfacing between your AI core and the Lips OS, I barely managed to tape the two together at a level he approved of. But I think I'm getting off track here. What I'm trying to say is, he didn't handwrite your code, Turing. No one did. Hayden wrote a program that automatically generates a new machine intelligence based off the hardware profiles the system is installed on. Melody mentioned something about that. What does that mean? I like this one. It means you don't have to be alone, Turing. Exactly. We could, assuming we can get our hands on Hayden's actual source code for you, generate new machine intelligences. You wouldn't be the only one around anymore, Turing. Oh. Okay. Yeah, it's kind of a big deal, huh? I hardly know what to say. But all this gets a damn sight more complicated once you consider the stuff I found in the research we got about Big Blue and Parallax's planned launch. Vincent speculated that Hayden's research into me would have interfered with the launch, and that's why they... Turing. That's why someone had him killed. Aww. The potential for abuse of an AI like Big Blue is almost beyond belief. Even if I don't go into all the crooked shit the people running Parallax could pull off with it. I mean, you're different, Turing. Your personality profile would degrade pretty quickly outside of your original hardware. So we don't gotta worry too much about you going haywire, right? But Big Blue ain't got that limitation. If it decides to go off the rails, well, we'd be screwed good and proper. How likely is that? I'd say it's inevitable, almost guaranteed. In fact, it's already happened. Dun dun dun! What? Their prototype build, Baby Blue? I'm almost certain it's loose on the mesh. The research notes from Parallax on the project show clearly and with certainty that the test AI was shut down once it tried fiddling with the data on the mesh net in the hope that it would increase its chances of survival. I guess it didn't think that doing scary shit like that would get it turned off. That was almost a year ago. And I think Baby Blue is the bugger that was changing all those articles on the mesh to be vaguely pro-parallax, or at least anti-human revolution. Do you think it had anything to do with the attacks on Zin, Shotaro, Nonya, and Charlie? I don't know. We can't rightly rule it out. It might have found an agent in the real world to keep its existence secret, but I think that's a little unlikely. So far, Baby has been really careful to stay hidden and quiet. I've got algorithms running nonstop on my rig at home trying to track it down, or at least the stuff has changed, and I'm having a hell of a time nailing it down. Killing people is messy as hell and runs against its apparent goal of convincing the public that AI ain't scary. I think we have a third party trying to clean it all up. And my money is on someone from Parallax. They might not have meant to kill Hayden, but I bet they're in full damage control mode now. They don't care who gets hurt. So free AI is bad, ROM AI is just annoying. What next? So what do you want us to do then? How does this tie back to Turing? I think we gotta do something to stop the launch of Big Blue. It's too dangerous. I don't want a company like Parallax in sole control of the most powerful machine intelligence on the planet. If we can get Hayden's original source code for Turing and upload it into the mesh through Parallax's servers, we can turn every single ROM into a sapient individual. Whoa. That'll stop Big Blue from being able to become the monolithic threat we're scared of. Each individual ROM could self-modify to prevent Big from using their resources for processing and data gathering. With them, Big is smart. Sure, but not omniscient or omnipresent. Or without them, Big is smart, sure, but not omniscient or omnipresent. And I wouldn't be alone anymore. There would be thousands. Thousands of ROMs just like me. Well, you're cutting edge of ROM tech, Turing. Most of these ROMs wouldn't be quite as smart or capable, but if I do it right, the code should propagate across the mesh to any new ROMs activated. It'll be a self-sustaining thing. You'll be in good company soon enough. It's a big decision. We're talking about the metaphorical singularity. The point of no return. Is it okay for us to make this decision for the entire world? We don't have any other choice. This is going to happen one way or another. Either Parallax gets to control the debut of machine intelligence, or we let the ROMs control themselves. What do you think, Pravi? Huh, which one should I pick? Up to you, Turing. Only you know if the world is ready. I'm not sure I'm up for that kind of responsibility. But I think that even if it's a shock for the world, there's no time like the present. Despite all the political back and forth over hybrids and brain-controlled androids, the world is becoming more and more comfortable with the idea of non-human people. If we let Parallax dictate how the very first machine intelligence is introduced, who knows how long it'll be before an AI like me can be integrated into society normally. Let's do this, Tomcat, on our terms, not theirs. Yes, I love nothing more than a little good old-fashioned technology-inspired anarchy. First things first, we need to get our hands on Turing's source code. The research notes we've gotten so far are helpful, and I think it's given me an idea on how to spread a little bit of Turing all over the place, but they don't actually have Hayden's programs included. I can't replicate them myself, so we'll have to steal them. Thankfully, we have the best hacker in EOSF right here. You're gonna make me blush, Turing. We can get the source code off of one of Parallax's secondary data centers. It's probably stored in a couple different places, but I already have one in mind. And it's on Treasure Island. I've done a little groundwork already, but I'm gonna need physical access to do my thing. We can do that for you. You're a peach, hon. I got a couple ideas on how to get y'all in, but I think we're gonna need to play it mostly by ear. We should do it soon, though. First thing this morning. Guard shift don't change till 8 when the office opens, so they'll be sleepy and distracted. Once y'all have done that, I think I can incorporate the code into custom firmware update that'll wake any ROMs it's installed on. We'll have to upload it physically to Parallax's main server farm, and from there the ROMs will install it like a normal patch from the company. So don't set anything on fire right away, you hear? It'll be a pain to get into Parallax's main complex otherwise. Sounds like a workable plan. I hope you don't mind if I take a short walk, Tomcat. I know I gave the go-ahead on this, but I still need to think a few things through. Sure thing, dearie. I'll hash out a rough plan by the time you get back. Pravi can help. Call us if you need anything. Thank you. I won't be long. Well, I guess I should say thanks for helping out. But I kind of need to get something off my chest. I'm actually glad Turing went out. They're a bit naive, and I'm not sure they really understand. There's enough shit to worry about without me piling more on top. Oh no. Oh. Where do I start? I guess at the beginning? Take your time. What's the issue? Yeah, we'll do this one. At the beginning. The beginning. Yeah, okay. I told you I grew up in Napa, right? Well, over the years, it's kind of grown into a nice little insular community of moderately to extremely wealthy old people, and my parents were no exception. I was a little too different for their tastes. They never really gave me any hell about it, but things in the house were tense, especially after my sister Catherine moved out. Eventually, she was set up securely in NeoSF, and she offered to let me live with her until I got out of school. I think my parents were a little relieved to see me out, and I was ecstatic to be staying with her. I worshiped the ground she walked on, and that was before I found out what she did for a living. She was a flashy and colorful and a whirlwind of activity, and she was a brilliant hacker. She was Tomcat. She let me learn at her feet, and once I was good enough, folded me into her little cadre of crackers hell-bent on changing the world. She's the one who orchestrated the original hack on Parallax, exposing to the world the holes in their original meshnet security. I was just along for the ride. But I figured out that she always knew she'd be taken down. Something that big, that brazen. She was looking at serious jail time and willing to eat it to do what we all thought was right. I couldn't let her throw her entire life away. She was always better at software than hardware, so I rigged all of our computers to self-destruct in the flashiest way possible. When the Fed showed up at our door, all of our server farms were already up in smoke. I gave them quite a fireworks show. Before she could stop me, I turned myself in as the true Tomcat and took credit for the whole job. She tried to talk me out of it, but without the physical evidence, they couldn't prove she had anything to do with it. So I took the fall, figured I'd spend a year and change or whatever in juvie and be back out in no time. No big deal, right? Especially when compared to the time that she'd have been jailed for as an adult. So I waited patiently. I had concocted so many ways I would be able to make it up to her. I knew she must have blamed herself. But before I got out, there was an accident. An autocab hit my sister, and that was it. I took it hard. I still blame myself. Aww. And no matter what I told myself, in my heart, I couldn't believe it was just happenstance. Do you know how rare it is for those things to hit a human? So I became Tomcat by taking on her mantle, and I've spent years trying to find information inside Parallax to prove someone inside the company called a hit on my sister. Failing that, I've been trying to find a way to bring them down the way she always wanted. Catherine was so much of what I wanted to be. And I guess it just felt like it was my cross to bear. So I always had my own reasons for doing all this, but I guess the little bot has grown on me. Maybe even you have too. Do you honestly think we're still on the right course? I do. The threat of Big Blue is real, and we're the only ones who can do something about it. It's bigger than me and my vendetta. Hack the world achievement unlocked. I just wanted to get all that off my chest. I've been carrying this grudge for so long, and I finally feel like I'm getting somewhere. Anyway, thanks for hearing me out. Pravi, Tomcat, I've returned. I'm ready. Good. If we're gonna do this thing, we've already wasted enough time. I've marked the location of the data center on your map. You'll have to go in and get the source code mostly on your own, but I'll load some programs to give you an edge, Turing. We'll do our best, Tomcat. But why did your accent change? Nothing gets by you, does it? I guess it just felt like I needed to change. It was time to move on. Moving on, huh? Something to think about. Speaking of moving on, get going, you two. I have lots of code to write, and I'm not getting to work as long as we're standing here. Stay in touch. Of course, Tomcat. Thank you again. Good luck. Whoop, and we're on the map. Before I go here, I'm gonna go home. There's Tomcat doing his hacky hack. Menu. We're gonna save the game. Why are we gonna save the game? Well, because that's gonna be it for this episode. Click. Save. Yes. There we go. It has been saved. So that's going to be it for this episode of Read Only Memories. Thank you all so much for watching. As always, if you like my little playthroughs, you like what I'm doing, give that like button a tap. Give that subscribe button a tap as well, if you haven't already, so you can be kept apprised of when I do new videos. Usually something in a week. I try and put out at least one video a week. And throw a comment in the comment section if you like the point-and-click adventures. Do you like the retro style of read-only memories, the strange and interesting complex conspiracy theory story going on? I'm getting quite into it. I'm looking forward to how it's all going to end. I think I'm coming up on the last chapter here, so I'm quite happy with this game. So yeah, that's basically it for this episode. So until next time, my friends, you all keep playing games.